Another thing, I don't think we know exactly what time the impact occurred at this point. I wouldn't want to say, you know, that 2018 is the impact time. It's, you know, all I know is it's fantastic, you know, what is happening.
Overcome by euphoria at this stage, no one had any idea of the sheer scale and range of information that the Jupiter collision was about to produce. Saturday, July the 16th, 1994, was the beginning of the most remarkable week in the history of astronomy. Fragment A struck at 11 minutes past 8 GMT, punching a hole in the outer atmosphere. It was 14 minutes late. Although the rock was only 1 kilometer across, pictures taken from the side showed a huge fireball rise over 1,000 kilometers above the cloud tops before spreading out into a vast thin disk. Every day brought more fragments, and with each, more questions about the makeup of Jupiter and the dying comet. Data poured in from telescopes around the world, thousands of images specially enhanced to catch every aspect of the impacts. It quickly became clear that every fragment was different and had a different effect on the surface of Jupiter. Some were more fragile than others. P and M disappeared without a trace. But when fragment G smashed home on Monday, it released 24 times the energy of the first collision. The blast rose almost 3,000 kilometers above the planet's surface with a flash of infrared that overloaded several telescopes on Earth. This explosion dredged up material from deep within Jupiter, and analysis of the light emitted revealed the presence of sulfur, evidence for the first time that the beautiful colors of Jupiter are caused by compounds of sulfur. Gradually, the planet's south pole became littered with impact hotspots. Each disturbance lasted far longer in the stormy atmosphere than anyone had anticipated, filling the upper cloud layers with dark-colored debris. Some have suggested these disturbances could create new features as dramatic as the Great Red Spot, a vortex which has lasted hundreds of years. As the last days of the impact approached, the questions kept piling up. What can the impact shockwaves tell us about Jupiter's core? What was the makeup of the original comet? And will new rings form around the giant planet? Puzzles that will keep some astronomers busy for the rest of their careers.
Well, I think that P. Shoemaker Levy 9 has already gone down in the history books, for sure. We already knew it'd be an historic event, regardless of what was seen. But after looking at the images on the monitor that showed the plume from the side, and then as the impact site rotated around on the planet, we could see not only the longer-lasting plume that was still visible, but the shockwave, the acoustic wave, propagating out. For nucleus A, that told us we're going to get a big scientific return from this whole sequence of events. So it was better than our wildest dreams.
Sorry to barge in on y'all, but I just wanted to tell you, I'm from Charleston County Schools, and our kids have been working since January on this. And so we had four teachers come up here.
We're the ones that are wearing
these t-shirts. We had them designed. Can I take your picture?
Surely.
Sure.
Do you mind? I appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
I didn't mean to interrupt your breakfast, but I just got to.
Oh, we're so pleased you're doing it. I think it's absolutely
you.
Wonderful.
Bye-bye. You have a wonderful time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I think we'll slip in and have some breakfast.
Don't worry about me. Happy, my love. Let's say that our little show is over and so the story ends.
It delivered. How about it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's great. It's great.
If you see somebody new, someone who looks good to you, you're free, don't worry about me.
Long-awaited collision between a fragmented comet and Jupiter. It provided a field day for astronomers the world over.
12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start.
July 16th, 1969. The most powerful rocket yet built, the 100-meter-high Saturn V, lifts three U.S. astronauts off planet Earth. It's the start of an historic mission to put man on the moon. The bold venture began in 1961 when President John F. Kennedy gave U.S. space engineers until the end of the decade to land a man on the moon and bring him safely back. At the time, they had yet to put a man in space orbit. But on July 20th, 1969, the blurred television pictures showed they'd risen to Kennedy's challenge.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Exactly 25 years later, astronomers around the world were crewing telescopes to observe a different kind of space spectacular. The excitement was generated here at Mount Palomar in Southern California, by geologist Eugene Shoemaker, his astronomer wife Carolyn, and amateur astronomer David Levy. The telescope the trio use is a 60-year-old 18-inch instrument. It can film an exceptionally wide field of sky, which makes it perfect for picking up fast-moving objects. The team is credited with discovering dozens of comets, and in March this year, they didn't know it, but they were about to add another to the list. One that astronomers would be able to watch self-destruct. But it was touch and go. They worked by painstaking scanning of the film the telescope takes. And that night, low cloud nearly persuaded them not to waste their time. But they decided to carry on focusing on Jupiter. Jupiter, its revolutions here speeded up, is the giant of the solar system planets, 300 times the mass of Earth.
We knew we had something very unusual. It was so unusual, we were a little unsure just what we were dealing with.
So I started to scan it, and Jupiter was a big, overexposed-looking blob on one side. And I started at the top and across and down. And then as I moved across, about a little